Hi, you know almost everything there's to know about how to buy a property in Italy. Many foreign potential investors, like you, would like to own a second home to spend their holidays in one of the most beautiful countries in the world, but at the same time would like to zero the costs of maintenance, routine maintenance, taxes, etc. and manage to get an income from it. However, there are some aspects that may slow down the race to buy in the bel paese. In the meantime, I would like to start by giving you a figure.
When we are contacted by a potential buyer interested in buying a second home, we obviously conduct an interview with the customer, aim to knowing in details all their needs in order to be able to submit the most suitable solution for his search. One of the questions we ask potential customer is, are you buying your second home for private use or to turn into an extra income? Well, in 80% of cases, they reply to our question with a lot of questions, such as, I would also like to rent it out to tourists, but where do I start from? How does it work in Italy? What's the legislation? How much does the tourism rental make? For obvious reasons of distance, I cannot deal with the management. Who will take care of it? There are those who live their dream of owning a property in Italy in order not to bear the expenses that would be incurred to maintain a second home in a foreign country. All this happens for all these reasons. The bureaucratic aspect is not known. Same for the fiscal aspect of renting a second home. Logistical reason. I live far away from my second home, located in a foreign country, for example. Don't worry. With this video, I'll try to provide you all the elements needed to be able to perform this important step and to realize your dream of owning a little piece of Italy. Which are rules for renting out a house in Italy to tourists? Well, let's start by understanding what is meant by short leases for the Italian law. Are considered short leases lease contracts for residential buildings of a duration not exceeding 30 days, including those that provide for the provision of services for the supply of linen and cleaning of premises, entered into by individuals outside the exercise of business activities. Okay, I'll try to simplify things for you to better understand. In other words, you can only rent properties that have an habitative intended use. You can check the destination of use of a property by verifying the cadastral category, requesting a cadastral inspection. To be considered as a short lease, the maximum duration of the rental must not exceed 30 days. If the rent is more than 30 days, it's obligatory by law to register the contract with the revenue agency with the consequent registration fees. Each person can rent no more than 3 properties. Otherwise, the revenue agency will consider this as a real business activity with the obligation to apply for a VAT number. What's the procedure to rent out a house in Italy? Well, you have to communicate to the municipality where the house is located that you want to rent it to the tourists. Once your application has been accepted, the municipality will provide you an identification code. Keep it. The identification code must be provided in any online ads. This way, the revenue agency will be able to verify the type of structure, the features of the property and the owner. You'll have to make sure that each guest has his or her ID or passport. And you have to send all this data to the police headquarters of the province where the house is located. Be aware of timing. You have from 6 to 24 hours from the arrival of your guests, depending on how many nights they will stay at your home. You must inform ISTAT, National Statistical Office, of the flow of your guests for statistical purpose. And how much can I earn in percentage per year? Well, it obviously depends on some factors, including geographical area, large cities, the flow of tourists is constant throughout the year, but the offer is wide. The touristic flow in seaside and mountain resorts is strictly linked to the season. In all cases, an old but gold rule always applies: location, location, and location. Marketing investment you make in your home. It's better if you do yourself or with a specialized agency. Well, this choice is yours. Keep in mind, you have to cover all costs earning something. If you are a good businessman, you can do your home. If not, it's better to engage an agency. When I say marketing investment, I mean not only the promotional aspect, advertising on specialized sites, etc., but also a series of actions aimed to making the potential guests perceive an added value on your property when compared to all other in the market. To give you an idea of the result, however, it's useful that you know about the cost of maintaining a property in Italy. The topic is discussed in the last video. You should take in consideration the idea of applying for a mortgage from an Italian bank that you would pay back with the incomes you would get from renting out a house in Italy. Doing this kind of financial analysis could be your winning ace. In any case, here is the average gross annual yield from which expenses and taxes must be deducted of a property in Italy. For seaside resorts, from a minimum of 3% to a maximum of 7%. For large cities, from a minimum of 4% to a maximum of 8%. In terms of taxation, if you own a house that you want to put on the rental market, you have two possibilities. The IRPEF tax, that doesn't have a fixed percentage. The higher the earnings, the more taxes you'll pay. Basically, you have to add up all your annual earnings and annualities, and depending on the amount reached, you'll be taxed with a certain percentage. You can opt for the cedolare secca. This form is cheaper if you don't have many expenses to deduct. The rate is 21% for short-term rentals, calculated on 100% of the amount. Here are some recommendations. Makes an insurance that cover you from any kind of damage to property or persons, and that covers any accidents to guests who will spend their holidays in your home. This also must include any outside garden, swimming pool, etc. The property must comply with the building and town planning regulations and be certified as being fit for use by the municipality where your property is located. As in the previous case, in case of any damage suffered by your guests, in case of irregularity of the property, the insurance will not compensate for the damage. The property must be equipped with the certification of technological systems up to date. Otherwise, in case of accidents to guests, the insurance will not compensate for the damage caused. I advise you to always ask in advance payment for the rent before the guest to whom you give the keys enters, and to ask for a security deposit that can cover you from any damage that may have been caused to the property. Don't miss the next video, because maybe it's the most important of the whole course. See you soon! Ciao ciao!